Welcome back to Musclemania 93, the natural bodybuilding championships from Redondo Beach, California. I'm Richard Blade, along with Mr. North America, Jim Quinn.
Hello, this is Moses Anjala from Oakland, California. I want to say thanks to all of my friends in Oakland, San Pablo, and Buckley. Nice to be here, Musclemania.
He is certainly in great shape, Jim.
Yeah, he's an old soccer player, and that's what he feels gave him his great legs. Look at the calves and the hamstrings on this guy.
And also, he says that when he's training in the gym, he just trains basics.
I do the regular basic stuff, but I just love doing it. When I started bodybuilding, I was into everyday arms. Before I it just came out genetics, just like my core. From playing soccer, it was big, so it's genetic, nothing sophisticated.
And his training has certainly worked for him. He is in perfect proportion.
Yeah, he's thick all over. He started training 7 years ago at 28, and now at 35 years old, he looks fantastic.
Time for our next competitor.
Hi, my name's Art Leinbach. I'm from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. First, I'd like to thank my training partner, Donna Everly. I couldn't have done it without her. I'd also like to thank members of the East and West Shore Health Clubs, Doug Siegfried, and the Pennsylvania State Police. Thank you.
Well, so far in this contest at Musclemania, we've had a construction worker, we've had a surfer, a manager of a health spa, now we've got a state trooper.
Yeah, we got a big diversity of occupations in these groups. And this guy is a state police trooper with a very vast and diverse background in several sports, including football and basketball, volleyball.
And in addition to the sports, he does a lot of public service. He actually goes out to the schools and speaks to kids about staying off drugs. And he does no drugs. This is a natural bodybuilder, but look at his thickness.
This is a very thick and dense middleweight on stage here. A guy that's a natural bodybuilder like Arthur has to train very, very heavy, basic movements, a lot of time off out of the gym, and taking in a lot of calories, especially a lot of dietary intake of protein.
And it certainly has paid off. He's been competing for 5 years, won a lot of East Coast titles.
And he speaks to many kids about staying away from drugs. So that's his way of contributing to the various groups around him.
Looking great for a state trooper. If ever he pulls you up and gives you a ticket, don't argue with this guy.
Yeah, I think it'd be a bad idea to get out of the car.
Great shoulders and back development, too.
Yeah, finishing up his routine here, he's showing off that back development with a back double bicep and a couple different variations of that pose. And finishing with a whole bunch of most muscular. Very artistic poser. A lot of power posing and then changing it up with a little bit of artistic stuff.
Next up, it's Mike Rizzo.
Hi, my name is Mike Rizzo, and I'm from Voorhees, New Jersey. I'd like to thank my family and friends who gave me a great deal of support for the show, and especially my friend Brock Evans, who gave me an unbelievable amount of encouragement and good training advice. Thank you.
Now, part of his training advice is he works each body part just once a week.
Yeah, he likes using heavy weights and low reps, and training naturally, that's a necessity. They're not going to have the recuperative capabilities that people that are using enhancing drugs will, and he's been training very thick, and he's got a classic physique, and yet he's very thick and dense.
And to match that classic physique, he's got a classic posing routine here.
And I tell you, he's also come in shape here. You can see this guy's body fat levels as he turns around here in the lower back. That's kind of a telltale sign, Rich. A lot of good bodybuilders hold that fat in that lower back, that within that Christmas tree area, and he's got virtually none back there.
Big smile on stage to impress the judges and the audience.
Yeah, he's got a lot of charisma. And for a big guy and a dense guy, he moves very, very well. He's doing a lot of lunging here, a lot of artistic poses.
Now, Mike says it's not just his workout that keeps him in such good shape. He says he's blessed with something, and that thing he's blessed with is good genetics. And this is what he told us.
I was fortunate enough to get wide shoulders and a small waist from my parents and good muscle insertion, so sometimes if you have good shape and good proportion, you don't have to be a huge freaky monster to do well in competitions.
Great routine, matches the music perfectly, great poser.
Crowd's eating it up.
Hi, my name is Ishmael Gonzalez, and I'd like to thank Dave for coming down here, and it's a pleasure to be here in the Musclemania.
Dave's his training partner, and Ishmael is no stranger to Musclemania. He's comfortable on this incredible stage that we've got going with the lights and the sound. This is actually his third Musclemania competition.
God, Rich, there are some pretty impressive bodybuilders in this middleweight class. These guys are thick, dense, and symmetrical. This is a real tough class. I wouldn't want to judge this one.
Now, he's been training for just a few years. In fact, he started 7 years ago as just a hobby.
Now he's determined to turn professional in the IFBB, and he's presently a personal trainer. So that keeps him in the gym. God, I'd have a tough time doing that. I have a hard enough time getting in there an hour and a half in the morning and an hour and a half at night. It gets a little monotonous. But judging from his physique here, it doesn't seem to be a problem for Ishmael.
He's 5'6 and weighs 175 pounds and must have a very low body fat ratio.
Yeah, you can see this guy's come in shape. And I tell you, like I said before, the previous guys in this class, this is a tremendous class in terms of density and symmetry.
And as you were saying, Ishmael was telling me a little earlier that he wants to turn pro and go to the IFBB.
One day I'll turn pro because of the reason that I am dedicated. I believe in hard work, sweat, consistency in the gym, and just genetics too. I feel that I have good genetics in this bodybuilding. I feel I have the frame and the structure for one day being pro.
Good looking guy too. I hear that he was quite the center of attention out here.
Yeah, he was very sought after during the midst of this contest. A lot of talent agents were trying to convince him to move out here.
Hi, my name is Tito Raymond. I'm from Wakefield, Massachusetts. I'd like to thank everybody at home for the support and encouragement, and all the rest of the guys in the middleweight class for the battle on stage. That's what the sport's all about.
The battle on stage. I like the way he puts that.
He's probably got a battle in his own household. He says he comes from a family of 11, and his younger brother is also a competitive bodybuilder. So I imagine there's a couple of fights at the refrigerator during contest time.
Can you imagine the dining room table?
Yeah, and it's probably, imagine his mother breaking up fist fights over a rice cake.
I would not like to get in a fist fight with this guy. He is in incredible shape. And he also said when he gets into the gym, he likes to basically not pull any punches. He says for himself, he sets no limits when he's training.
Well, my training philosophy is that, again, not to set a limit on yourself. To go into the gym with an attitude of progressing every day that you go in there. That every time that you go into the gym and you leave, you're gonna do something that you didn't do before. That you're gonna be a little stronger, you're gonna get a little bigger, you're gonna get a little more shape. The training philosophy that I have is to use a variety of exercises and an instinctive training.
And that variety of exercises certainly has paid off. Look at the muscle development on this guy.
Yeah, what he just said about instinctive. After a while and several years of training, these guys get to know what works for them, and that's the term instinctive training.
Certainly working for Tito Raymond, wrapping up the middleweight class. Stick around when we come back. We'll have the results in the middleweight class, plus the light heavyweights coming up on Musclemania.
Well, we're at Musclemania tonight to see all the...
Musclemania.
Oh, we're at Musclemania tonight to see all the good-looking guys. Right, Deb?
And I'm backing her up.
Looking at me in this picture, it's hard to believe that just 20 months later, I would win the National Masters title. Metrics made that possible.
Being in the best shape of my life isn't just a personal goal. It's my business. I have to use what works, and that's why I switched to Metrics.
To find out why 9 out of 10 bodybuilders prefer Metrics over all other nutritional products, call 1-800-356-9200. Call now for your free Metrics brochure.
Welcome back to Musclemania 93 from Redondo Beach, California. I'm Richard Blade, along with Mr. North America, Jim Quinn, and we have the results in the middleweight class. In fifth place, it's Tito Raymond. In fourth place, Ishmael Gonzalez. In third place, AK Lineback. In second place, Mike Rizzo. And in first place, as you thought, Jim, because of the thickness, Moses Ajala.